What's up guys, Kill the Cloud here, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how to do force fields or jellyfishes. They're basically the same thing. Force fields are when the vapor wraps around the O and just stays wrapped around and moves. Jellyfish is where there's a stream behind it. They're basically the exact same thing, very small differences in between them, but everyone kind of gets them mixed up. There are two different differences with them, the stream and non-stream, but everyone kind of gets them mixed up, so it's fun. Jellyfish force field, it's basically the same exact way to produce them. So you have three basic rules with jellyfish and force fields. One, you can't have, which of these four, you can't have any wind or anything, so you have to make sure it's very dead where you're at. It makes the force field in jellyfishes for beginners a lot easier. When there's a little more wind in the room, it's harder to get consistent O's unless you're used to working in that environment. You get what I'm saying? For beginners, it's really easy to work in a dead airspace. Two is you gotta get used to popping O's. What I mean by popping, I use this word on my channel a lot. It just means shooting out O's. You have to shoot out O's that are consistently shaped and how you want them to be shaped so you can vape bend them, push them. So the third is to push, okay? So I typically use two hands and go left and right side of the O, and it really gets a good spread on the O. Some people can do one hand, their body, you know, their forehead, anything. You can really use any part of your body to vape bend to make the O bigger. I like to use both my hands just for even placement though, so it's all up to you on that, whatever you feel more comfortable on. If you guys are watching this video and you're not good at bending yet, I recommend you guys watch my how to vape bend video, and it'll really help you guys out. And then come back to this video once you get it down, and it's going to be a lot easier to produce force fields and jellyfishes with the knowledge that you have from that video. So, and then the, what is it, the fourth step is when you're done vape bending, you want to make your nose relatively close to the top of the circle, and then your mouth is probably most likely going to be close to the center. And you want to have, let's say here's the O right here, I'm going to have my mouth like this, and I'm going to drop vapor like this. So there's different things to do with different size O's. If the O is about this big, typically I'm going to drop vapor like this. Very small. Because when the O is smaller, the diameter is smaller, you don't want to drop a lot of vapor inside that O. It's going to dissipate the entire thing. And then you're going to get frustrated because you're like, I can't get the force field down. It keeps dissipating my O's. It's because you're dropping too much vapor inside. So if you drop too much vapor like this in a small O, that's not going to wrap it around. It's going to completely destroy it. If the O is bigger now, if you have an O about this big that you vape bend, and to drop it, you're going to want to drop light puffs, but larger coverage, if you know what I mean. If the O is this big, something like that, okay? So it really depends on the size of the O. Typically for beginners, I want you guys to drop a small little bit of vapor in the center, and that will be enough to wrap it around. So, I'm gonna cover the three steps in making the force field. The first tip was just no air, but here are the three tips. So, make sure there's dead air. Pop your O. Follow it while you're pushing it slowly. Trail it behind it. It's gonna get bigger. Then I'm going to take either another hit or have the same vapor in my lungs that I saved from inhaling and popping the first O. Then drop a little bit of vapor inside that O and then let it go. Don't move. If you move backwards, right after you're done, it's going to pull all that vapor backwards and dissipate that O. So try to not move backwards, okay? If anything, if you're in a large area, try to move forwards. And now continue the momentum of the O to push it farther. Okay? So here it is, guys. Alright, so those are force fields. Now, that moment that you saw when the O wasn't really going the way I wanted to, I just forgot about it. I was just like, that's not even worth my time. When the O is wobbling and it's kind of light and it's thick in one area and dissipating in another, once I drop vapor inside, it's going to dissipate the entire thing. You want to make sure it's milky and evenly thick around all. There's no sides of a circle, I get that. I know I was corrected before, but you want to make sure that every part of that circle is evenly thick with vapor. If it's thin in one area, it's going to mess up the entire thing because that's going to be its weakest point and it's going to break. Okay? So take your time, guys. When you're shooting an O, vape end it, go slow, come up to it. So I like to shoot down and then vape end and then it evens out. So I'm never going to shoot an O upwards and be like, it's too much tracing I have to do. I have to come up and then vape end it down. It's too hard to do. So what you want to do is, since there's gravity and the O's are most likely going to fall downwards just by you shooting them, you're going to shoot an O regular. It's going to drop down. You're going to vape bend it and even it out so then it comes centered. And then you drop your vapor in and then it wraps around. So it's very basic to do, guys. Force field jellyfish is the same thing, basically. You want to get that vapor placed right. You don't want to overpower the O with too much vapor. It's going to dissipate it. You want to keep it nice and steady. A little bit goes a long way with force fields. So I highly recommend for beginners, when you're doing O's, drop a little bit of vapor in and see how good of a force field you can get, and then slowly add more vapor as you get used to making force fields and vape bending how you want to do it. It's a very simple trick. It just takes a little bit of practice, especially when you're in a room when there's a little bit of draft and stuff. It's gonna be really hard to create these. You want to have no draft at all in your rooms. You want to have no air movement at all, and you want to have good lighting. If it's a dark room and you're trying to see your vapor, it's going to be really hard. You want to visualize and see what you're doing to help you tinker with things to make the force field or jellyfish better. So I suggest some lighting up here and maybe some lighting towards you, you know, so then you can see it vividly, okay? I'm going to try a few more. So the thicker that O is, the more it's going to wrap around, because when you're shooting an O, it's moving like this. When you pop it out of your mouth, when you shoot out of your mouth, all of the circle is moving like this, all around. So when you drop vapor inside, it's going to pull that vapor through the O and then wrap it around, making the jellyfish, okay? So guys, that's basically the jellyfish. Hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I'm recording on my phone, so if the HD is a little more messed up than my traditional cam, my webcam inside, then I apologize for this. The audio, I hope it's decent on my phone. But guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Peace out. Have a great time practicing these jellyfish and force fields. They're really fun once you get them down, and they're really cool when you do trick comps and stuff with different combos around it. Once you get familiar with these force fields and jellyfishes, then you'll be able to do different things. So now, guys, I'm just going to joke around, do a few different vape tricks and stuff, and then end the video, guys. So, guys, peace out. Have a great day or night. Vape on. Be safe.